This is the SQA 2017 National 5 Mathematics Paper 2, and we're getting near the end, question 13, where you're given two identical shapes to form a logo, and you have each shape being part of a circle. Now, I've drawn some figures in on it, so I'll explain what they are in a wee while. And basically, they want you to get the height of the logo. Alright, so the idea is you get the height of one of them and just double it. Okay, so here we have, let's see how these numbers work, okay? Now, the radius of each circle is 14 centimetres. That means that from there to there is 14. So you might have seen the fact that I've drawn a line from there to there and a line down. I've made a right angle triangle here. So that's 14. Where did the 12 come from? Well, from there to there is 48. That means half the 48, these are both 24, half the 24, and you get 12. So we can now use Pythagoras to get x. X squared is 14 squared, take 12 squared. There's the working there, which is 52. So x is the root of 52, which is 7.2. Of course, you can get the height of one and double it, like I said earlier on, but I've just decided to take it nice and easy. What's the height? It's 14 plus 7.2, that's the same as that, plus another 7.2, plus another 14, taking it nice and easy, and you get 42.4. Let's turn to question 14 now. You are given a part of a circle, and you're given the length of the major arc. Now, there's the major arc. That's the bigger of the two possible arcs. If that one's drawn in, that would be the minor arc. You're told that that's 31.5. You're told the radius. Of course, we'll need that in a wee while. Right, okay, and they want to get the size of that angle there. All right, well, the length of an arc is the circumference divided up into 360 little bits, and then times it by the angle to get that there. Okay, now they actually tell you the arc length. Sometimes, most of the time, you're asked to find it, but they tell you that's 31.5. The circumference of a circle is pi times d. Pi times, and the radius is 6.4, so the diameter would be 12.8, and divide it up into 360 little bits, and that is 0.1117. That would be the length of the arc opposite 1 degree at the sector. Okay, so divide that by that to see how many degrees would there be for that one there. So it's 31.5 over 0.1117, and there we have it at 282. Let's go on to the next one, which is question 15. And this is the last one. We have a wind turbine has three blades, as shown below. And the height, which they tell you is 8 metres of the tip of the blade above the ground on each rotation, is given by 40 plus 23 cos x, where x lies between 0 and 360. And it's the angle blade A has turned clockwise from the vertical. Okay, so part A. Calculate the height when the angle is 60. Well, replace x with 60. 40 plus 23 cos 60, and you get 51.5 metres. Straightforward use of calculator. Again, make sure your calculator is on degree mode. And over onto B. Find the minimum height of the tip of blade A above the ground. Well, the formula for the height is given by that one there. And the only part of it that affects it is cos x. Now, the smallest cos x can ever be is minus 1. So, the smallest the height can ever be is when cos x is minus 1. So, it's 40 plus 23 times minus 1, which is 40, take 23, which is 17 metres. Part C, last question. Calculate the values of x for which the tip of the blade is 61 metres above the ground. So, we want h to be 61. So, 40 plus 23 cos x has to be 61. Take 40 from both sides. So, 23 cos x has to be 21. So cos x is 21 over 23, which is 0.913. So we're wanting the two values within the cos graph between 0 and 360. So there's a very quick diagram of cos x. And where is cos x 0.913? Well, whatever x value that is, that's pretty close to 1, that's 0.913 here, and over here, just to shy of 360, up there somewhere. Okay, do a shift cos of 0.913, and you get 24.1. So the cos of 24.1 is 0.913, and over here, you take it away from 360, and that gets you this corresponding one over here of 335.9. So the two answers are 24.1 and 335.9.